We are back on our digital stream providing you with additional coverage. So we're tracking that tornado warning that is coming through parts of Henderson County. It's going to be moving through there actually right in, or here in the, just the next couple of minutes. That's where we're going to see this circulation. Let me show you what we're finding here on the radar. Certainly a very intense thunderstorm that has the sign of trying to rotate. And at least at this point, that rotation has gone down just a little bit more, but it is right along the Navarro County line, moving over into Henderson County here very shortly, and even in the parts of Ellis County here, not too far from the Ennis area. So we'll watch that storm very closely. It's going to clip Henderson County and then move over into the Kaufman County area here very soon. And that's the track of that thunderstorm that we're certainly keeping an eye on. Let's go over to John here. He's looking at the timing of this storm as it moves in, and it could even clip, John, parts of Van Zandt County if it can hold together.
Yes, it probably will. And it looks like here in the next few minutes, going to be passing near Cottonwood, Gray's Prairie, Kemp around 455, Scurry just before 5 o'clock. Oak Grove should see this storm around 5 o'clock, Kaufman at 505, and Post Oak, Bend City 508, Oak Ridge 511, Talty 512, Terrell about 517, and Wills Point about 522. That is if the storm holds together. And right now, as Marcus mentioned, the circulation does not appear quite as strong, but still an indication of it there. And just going to be clipping just the western side of Henderson County here near Kemp as it moves up into that direction. So you folks there in that western part of Henderson County, and then later on up into the northwestern part of Van Zandt County, need to be keeping an eye on that storm as it travels in your direction. Moving along at a pretty good clip there, northeast about 50 miles per hour. Marcus?
Yeah, John, it certainly is moving quite fast, and the Weather Service still saying that the threat here, although rotation is maybe not as tight as what it once was when they issued the warning, the threat does still exist, and that's the environment that we are in, where you might see a brief pulse up, maybe come down for a moment, and then pulse back up again, given the situation. And there you can notice the circulation becoming a little bit more, crossing now into very extreme portions of Henderson County here, probably moving more so over land, as I don't have much in the way of county roads here, but the roads closer nearby, Farm to Market Road 85, it's going to be west of you, County Road 2142. The circulation will be just off to your west, right near Valley Farms, which is an extreme northern section there of Navarro County. Let me show you some additional radar data indicating the rotation. And there it is, where we do have at least some rotation that's occurring within this thunderstorm, and it's capable of producing a tornado. We don't have a confirmed report on that for us at this moment. But as John mentioned, this storm moving into Kaufman County, and then if it can hold itself together, and certainly the wind energy has it favorable as it is a supercell right now, could try to clip parts of Van Zandt County. So as we get closer to time, closer to 5:15, I'm sure we'll either get a new update on it or they will drop this warning altogether. That is the storm there. And while it doesn't necessarily look like a supercell, for those of you that know that meteorological term and the look of that storm, while it doesn't necessarily look like it, it has the characteristics of it. And that's where the cause for concern certainly does remain here at this point. And there are more storms even continuing off to the west for us there at this time. Let me take you over to the east just a bit, over in Van Zandt County, where we have some ongoing thunderstorms that are moving through. This is through Canton, through Edgewood, along US Highway 80. You notice here lots of lightning there, but there is not any indication that there are storms that are trying to rotate here in this area at this current moment. That's a good sign, but we certainly want to keep a monitor on that. Maybe some very weak rotation, but not as strong or pronounced. And you can notice here the track of this particular cell coming out of Navarro County that is a little bit stronger, not as much being shown there over in Van Zandt County, north of the city of Canton. Widen out the view, just kind of give a general radar reset, because we have some ongoing thunderstorms that are also pushing through elsewhere here in East Texas. These are not severe at this time, from Gregg County going all the way up toward the Cass County area, but they do have some pockets of some moderate to heavier rainfall. John gave this to me earlier near Pittsburgh. I believe it was along State Highway 11. There was some pea-sized hail that came down, and a few of the thunderstorms that came through there for a brief moment. But the main action continues to be right along this leading edge and even back out to the west, where a more potent line of thunderstorms are beginning to line up. And then ahead of that, some individual supercell type storms certainly could form here over this particular location for us as we continue to keep an eye on that. Again, this warning does continue until 5:15. The Weather Service just putting out what we call a significant weather advisory over in Cass and Marion County for some heavier thunderstorms that could maybe produce some gusty winds and some hail. That's going to be located over Cass, Marion, even for parts of Harrison County. You notice that here near the Linden area, in between Linden and Jefferson along Highway 59, and then off to the northwest there. Doesn't show any signs of sort of circulation occurring, but heavy rainfall can be expected. John?
Okay, Marcus. Yeah, still want to show you what's yet to come later on tonight. We're expecting this line, which is well out to the west there, developing west of the Metroplex and on southward to west of the Austin vicinity. That's going to hold together, and a lot very likely to hold together, I'll put it that way. And once it reaches our East Texas area, we'll begin to see that line moving in, produce some strong gusty winds, still have the potential to produce some tornadoes. And we're looking for that line somewhere probably in the 6 to 8 o'clock hour tonight to begin to move into our western portions of our area, and then on into the Tyler and Longview vicinities toward 9 to 11 o'clock tonight, finally getting into deep East Texas closer to the midnight hour, and then a couple of hours after that should be exiting on into Louisiana, and we would be done with this event. But still have more to come. This is just that these storms that are out ahead of this line, these are the ones that kind of can have their own environment to work with, a lot of energy to work with, and can become supercells like we are seeing with this storm there that's producing the possible tornado moving across that western tip of Henderson County. And then once the line gets here, those storms kind of do battle, and they can produce some strong strength line winds and still have that potential to produce some tornadoes. So that's what we'll be looking for later tonight. That line reaching our western counties about 6 to 8 o'clock, and then the Tyler Longview vicinity somewhere closer to the 9, 10, 11 o'clock hour and on into deep East Texas as we get closer to midnight. Marcus?
Yeah, absolutely, John. And ahead of that line before it comes in, that's why the Weather Service earlier today put out a tornado watch in coordination with the Storm Prediction Center, and that includes our western counties, and that's where we have our first tornado warning that's in effect coming through Navarro County, moving over through northwestern Henderson County, west of Cedar Creek Lake, and then moving over into Kaufman County at this point. So that's the watch that's in place. We will probably see a new tornado watch come out a little bit later this evening. There has not been discussion of that just yet. The real focus has really been in the area of the watch at this time, but a little bit later on this evening, as that line gets closer to us, I think at the very least, of course, we would have to have a severe thunderstorm watch. That would just be the first step, as we've been talking about the intensity of the strong thunderstorms that have been coming through, that have the potential to come through. Certainly we've been advertising that the last few days, so at the very least we will get some sort of watch. Most likely it would probably be a tornado watch, as the threat for some tornadoes would still exist here in this area for us at this current moment. Let me backtrack and give you a check of where we stand with our temperatures. We are into the 60s and the 70s. It's still quite warm, but of course, the focus still remains upon these ongoing showers and thunderstorms that continue to push on through. Let me give you a closer look at what's happening in our northeastern areas, and then we'll work our way back toward that Henderson County storm. And there you can notice here over the last hour, the progression here of that rain moving from southwest to the northeast. Initially over Longview, it was a healthy storm. It started to pulse up a bit more. We had heavy rain also near Kilgore too, but now you notice how much that is raced very quickly in an hour time off to the northeast, approaching near the Linden area for us. At this time, not severe here, but certainly packing a punch of a lot of lightning, as well as some gusty winds that are occurring within this particular part of the storm. We can check our severe threats. There could even be maybe some small hail being noted within those thunderstorms, but it doesn't look like that is it is anything that would be of the tornadic variety. Even checking the wind detection, this is just very strong winds that are being noted here. These strong areas of red, winds picking up maybe up to 20. I even think probably close to almost 30 miles an hour within some of these thunderstorms that are moving through the Cass County area. It gets a little bit lighter, not as intense. Marion County, Longview, you have round number three to come through your way here shortly. And then we focus our area back over to the west, back toward Grand Saline, and then the storm that's now moving through parts of Henderson County here at this moment. Let me switch back over to the Fort Worth radar site. Look a little bit closer with this storm. If you're just joining us here on our digital live stream, we have a tornado warning that is in effect for this region. It clips extreme northwestern Henderson County. It goes until 5:15 this evening because of the threat for a possible tornado that might try to form here. Here's where the circulation is, and we'll show you that by taking a look at our storm relative wind detection, an indication of where we have the rotating winds that could occur. And now it looks like that threat has now exited the northwestern part of Henderson County, now in Kaufman County, right over the Peeltown area. So the threat now for Henderson County looks to be over with, but it's moving up toward central Kaufman County and even toward the city of Kaufman also. From here, this is where we're going to have to watch things closely. Can it make a turn, move toward parts of Van Zandt County? Certainly is not out of the question. You'll certainly have some heavier rainfall that will pick up here shortly. We'll have to watch the motion here as this moves off to the north and to the northeast. John?
Okay, Marcus. Again, you've given us some good updates on that storm to the west, and we're also keeping an eye on these storms that are moving up toward Cass County at this point. Nothing severe there, but they do have the potential to produce some gusty winds, 30, maybe even 40 miles per hour, could even drop some small hail here and there as it continues to move into an environment that has not been worked over yet, so they still have the potential to develop. It's just that soon they should be moving out of our area on up toward the Texarkana vicinity, and right now moving up north of Lake of the Pines through Marion County and into Cass County at this point. Again, we're going to keep an eye on all of this activity as it continues to develop through the night, potential for some severe supercell storm to develop in that area there off to the northeast. Now, as we go back over toward the west and can show you what's going on there with that storm that was producing the tornado warning, as Marcus said, that has moved up into Kaufman County. So folks around Gun Barrel City and in that western tip of Henderson County, the danger appears to be over for you as the storm has moved toward the north and continues to track toward the northeast away from you. But it is affecting the Kaufman County area there near Kaufman. It's going to be moving into the Terrell vicinity at this point and could clip the extreme northwestern corner of Van Zandt County as it moves. Still have a tornado warning on that storm at this point. Marcus?
So, John, what they were saying here on the Weather Service chat is that it is weakening. They're seeing the indication of that, and we've noticed that too, which is great. They're not ready to cancel the warning just yet, but it will continue at least for right now until 5:15. Here's what we're going to do. We're about 10 minutes away from news time. We have a couple of more things to get ready since the threat of a tornado is out of the KETK and Fox 51 viewing area. We're going to end our digital stream for now. Going to keep an eye on this thunderstorm because next in line, if it tries to turn, would be Van Zandt County or even Ranger Hopkins County. So we'll keep a close monitor on that. Still got an active evening to come our way with some strong thunderstorms expected. We have a timing update for you and the look at future casts here in just a few minutes on KETK On Air. We will see you then.